What's up, guys, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we have some pretty interesting stuff to talk about concerning George Lucas, Darth Vader, and Anakin Skywalker. One of the most famous reveals in movie history is in fact the revelation that Darth Vader was Luke Skywalker's father and was the fallen Jedi Anakin Skywalker, whose story would later be massively expanded upon in the Star Wars prequels, where we learned that not only was Darth Vader Luke's father, but originally Anakin Skywalker had been the chosen one destined to bring balance to the Force and destroy the Sith. Famously, though, the reveal that Darth Vader was Luke Skywalker's father was the biggest twist and still remains quite possibly the biggest twist in cinematic history. However, this was not always the original plan for George Lucas in his Star Wars trilogy. However, it was one of the main ideas that George Lucas had. Originally, in fact, George Lucas never expected the reveal that Darth Vader was Luke's father to be as massive as it ended up being, and again, he didn't expect this revelation to impact audiences the way that it did. When talking about A New Hope 25 years later, this is what George Lucas said about this big reveal in Empire Strikes Back. "When I wrote the original Star Wars screenplay, I knew that Darth Vader was going to be Luke Skywalker's father, or at least in another draft I did. The audience did not. I always felt that this revelation, when and if I got the chance to make it, would be shocking, but I never expected the level of emotional attachment that audiences had to the development for Luke." In the original Star Wars, there's not really a hint that Darth Vader is in fact Luke Skywalker's father, and it was revealed to us that actually in the first draft of Empire Strikes Back, this was not to be the case, and that Darth Vader, at least for a time, was not going to be Anakin or Luke's father, and Darth Vader and Anakin were going to be two separate people entirely, with the whole Star Wars backstory being altered and changed. We actually know quite a bit about the original story of Darth Vader as well as Anakin, and thus, the topic of today's video, we'll be explaining the original backstory of many of these characters, as well as how it changed and how it ultimately massively changed when the prequel trilogy came around. In the first draft of Empire Strikes Back, Anakin Skywalker's Force ghost actually appears to Luke Skywalker and has a conversation with him, warning him about Darth Vader. This, of course, confirming to us that in the first draft, Anakin and Vader were two completely separate people. This was the dialogue between Anakin as a Force ghost and Luke in the Empire Strikes Back first draft of a screenplay. "Anakin, you've grown well, Luke. I'm proud of you. Did your uncle ever speak to you about your sister?" "My sister? I have a sister? But why didn't Uncle Owen?" "It was my request. When I saw the Empire closing in, I sent you both away for your own safety, far apart from each other." "Where is she? What's her name?" "If I were to tell you, Darth Vader could get that information from your mind and use her as a hostage." "Not yet, Luke. When it's time, Luke, will you take from me the oath of a Jedi Knight?" Later on in the screenplay, during the big confrontation between Luke Skywalker and Darth Vader, Darth Vader also had this line of dialogue: "You don't stand a chance against me. No more than your father did, anyway." In the original drafts of Star Wars A New Hope, there was still a shroud of mystery behind Darth Vader. George Lucas explained that on the Death Star, he had intel on every single person that worked on it, with the exception of Vader, as he's not really anybody that's employed directly by the Empire or the Death Star. Rather, Lucas went on to explain that Darth Vader is directly attached to the Emperor himself, and supersedes the authority of the Death Star or any Imperial. George Lucas also revealed that it was his original plan to not have any images of the Emperor himself appear in Star Wars A New Hope, as he wanted the big reveal of Palpatine in Empire Strikes Back to be massive, and he wanted this aura of mystery on who exactly was behind everything that was going on in the Star Wars galaxy, including Darth Vader. This was the original plot for how the Republic and the Jedi were going to fall, as well as how Palpatine and Darth Vader were integral in its fall, and eventually would take over the galaxy. According to original drafts, it was intended for Palpatine to have taken over about half the Senate years ago, but half the Senate again resisted his power, with half of the Senate attempting to have Palpatine impeached as Supreme Chancellor. When the Jedi were alerted, they sided with the half of the Senate that did not agree with Emperor Palpatine, and therefore became a massive threat to his rule, as again in the original backstory, there were a ton of people that originally opposed the rule of Darth Sidious, and the Jedi were brought in a little bit later. Mysteriously though, a lot of the senators that began opposing Palpatine began to mysteriously die, with it being revealed that they were being assassinated across the stars. By whom, though, is still unknown in George Lucas's original script. All we know is that all of the senators that opposed Palpatine were eventually killed off. This is when Darth Sidious would move on against the Jedi, with this being some of George Lucas's original comments on the original story. "There was a plot afoot when the Jedi tried to restore order. Darth Vader was still one of the Jedi. What he would do is catch the Jedi off guard, and using his knowledge of the Force, he would kill the Jedi without them realizing what was happening. This again sounds very similar to what we ultimately got in Revenge of the Sith, with Anakin Skywalker and the clone troopers storming the Jedi Temple and taking over. However, again in the original backstory, Anakin and Darth Vader were two separate people, both Jedi but separate. George Lucas explained that Emperor Palpatine would then reveal elite troopers that had been specifically designed to kill Jedi, separate from the clone troopers, as again it's pretty widely known, or believed at least, that the clone troopers that were originally spoken about in the Clone Wars were the villains of the Clone War, and it was because of their cloning that they became emotionally unstable and very dangerous, and actually worked for the Separatists and not the Republic. Of course though, this would later be changed, and the elite troopers that were working for Palpatine and the clone troopers became one entity in the prequel trilogy. However, again in the original drafts, the elite troopers that worked for Darth Vader and Palpatine and the clone troopers were separate. Anyway though, with Darth Vader now a Sith Lord, he took these elite troopers and began hunting down Jedi, killing hundreds of thousands of Jedi with the help of all of these troopers, troopers that would eventually become stormtroopers. In these original drafts though, George Lucas specified that after the first few waves of Darth Vader killing Jedi, there were only a few Jedi left in the galaxy that had managed to evade Vader, those Jedi being named as Obi-Wan Kenobi, Yoda, and Luke's father, again confirming that originally Anakin and Vader were two separate people. It was also George Lucas's original intention to have Anakin Skywalker be one of the last Jedi killed by Darth Vader, and the last Jedi to really put up a big fight against Vader, as the other Jedi fled into the unknown regions like Obi-Wan or Yoda, who also went into exile. But Anakin was sort of described as this last Jedi to make a stand against the tyranny of the new Empire. According to George Lucas, Anakin Skywalker was also one of the first members of the rebellion, and one of the few Jedi that actually helped the people of the galaxy establish a rebellion against the Empire. He was known as a heroic Jedi Knight who did not abandon his lineage as a Jedi Knight once the Empire arose, fighting against its tyranny, making him a prime target of Palpatine as well as specifically Vader. In this version, of course, though, Anakin also had two children, who he sent off into hiding, realizing that it was only a matter of time before Vader tracked him down. Therefore, he wanted to ensure that if he died, which he ultimately knew he would, there would be a new hope in the galaxy. According to various information, George Lucas actually took over control of the second draft of Empire Strikes Back, and this is where ultimately Darth Vader became Luke's father, with this being the annotation. The notion of Vader being Luke's father first appeared in the second draft. Vader became attracted by the dark side of the Force while he was training to become a Jedi. He became a Jedi and killed most of the other Jedi Knights. Ben fought Vader and pushed him down a nuclear reactor shaft. One of his arms was severed, and Ben believed that he had killed Vader. In fact, Vader survived and had become a partial cyborg or mutant. It is believed that in the original version of Star Wars, Darth Vader was just that, a simple monster and the person that would go on to kill Luke's father, and later face off against Luke Skywalker. However, when the second draft of Empire Strikes Back came around, George Lucas modeled Luke and Vader after his experiences with his own father. In the various conversations and arguments George Lucas had with George Sr. over taking over the family business, with George wanting to go off and be a filmmaker, but his father not believing that this was a viable source of income. This is later what George Lucas had to say about his own father and the experience he had with him. And again, once we read this, it explains exactly how this relates to the story of Luke and Vader. He lived to see me finally go from a worthless, as he would call it, a late bloomer, to actually being successful. I gave him the one thing every parent wants, to have your kid be safe and able to take care of himself. That was all he really wanted, and that's what he got. But there it is, my friends, the original story of Anakin Skywalker and the original backstory of Darth Vader, and why it was ultimately changed for the better. I want to say that I do really like the original backstory of Anakin and Vader, and this sort of revenge story, but I think the story that we ultimately got with Star Wars is far more impactful and generational defying. This idea that Luke Skywalker eventually redeems his father Darth Vader is so much more impactful than simply a revenge story, and the big reveal for me is one of the most massive parts in cinematic history, not only just in the Star Wars universe. Anyway though guys, I would love to hear what you guys have to think about this, and the original backstories for Anakin and Vader. And again, obviously, which one do you ultimately prefer, the original backstory or the Star Wars backstory that we got in Empire? As always my friends, thank you so much for watching, may the Force be with you, and have a great day.